everyone and welcome to AEA's Art Channel. My name is Elkjan Wiersma and today I'd like to show you how I painted this deer painting. And before I go into do that, it's quite a big canvas and especially the frame makes it look much bigger. And I really like this frame. I found it in a secondhand store where I work, and there was a few frames, and this one was one of them. And it's a little bit damaged, but yeah, I liked it so much. And as I said, it's a little bit damaged, but I don't think it's ruined the frame. It's still beautiful, so therefore I like to use it for my painting. And I think this painting does fit this frame very well. And the deer painting. I painted in a lot of the background with the airbrush, and therefore I like to use the Createx airbrush paint. And I hope you can see this. I will put a link in this video description. And so I did a lot of airbrushing in the background and a little bit of quite some bit on the flowers. And I also painted in some flowers, but I stayed very loose when in this field of flowers, because I like to give it a little bit of softer feel, and therefore I didn't needed a much detailed flower. So I stayed, I indicated the flowers and I airbrushed it over them to give that a looser feel. And for the deer, I painted that in detailed it with my acrylic paints, and I always like to use the Liquitex Basics, and sometimes I'm using the Winsor & Newton as a second option. I like that paint also, but yeah, my favorite is the Liquitex Basics, so most of the times I'm using that paint. And also on the deer, I only use the Liquitex Basics colors there. And I hope you like this tutorial. Let's get over the tutorial.
First, I start out with a base color, and that were for this painting a blue and a green, and I let those mix in with each other, and just to start and to get rid of the white of the canvas. And it's almost looking like an underwater world right now, but these are the colors I like to use for this painting in the farthest background, so I can build up my layers from here. And I like to paint in my main subjects with a mid-tone gray, so I know where they are, and it's a little bit easier for me to judge where what should go. And I'm missing a few clips of the airbrush here, so therefore those appeared quite quickly. And I had some problems with my camera. I thought it was on, but it wasn't on, so therefore I missed a few things. But yeah, I like to paint in the darkest colors first, most of the times with the airbrush, and build up from there. So, and also I try to with the airbrush to fill in what for me looks the farthest away, and build up from there. So I like to start out with the darkest colors and build up with the lighter colors. And for example, if you have the green, sometimes I layer in a bit of white and glaze over with the green, because the green is a transparent color, and therefore I like to build up with the white and the highlights and tint them later on. So I'm working from dark to light there. And here I'm making some texture. I've tried to give the indication of flowers, but I wouldn't like to for this painting to paint them in very detailed. I just like that softer feel, like I said in the beginning of this tutorial, and the softer feel of the flowers. So therefore I make some texture, and I will airbrush over it later on. And also here, working with my lights and my darks, those are so important. And I'm tinting the colors, but the lights and the darks are the most important in drawings and paintings. And I try to match my colors with my airbrush. I airbrushed in the flowers who were the furthest away. That last line of flowers is with the airbrush, and the other ones are painted with a paintbrush. And so I try to match my colors there, and if I'm not quite exact, because that's most of the time, because it can be quite hard to give the exact color you used in the background, I'm just glazing over a little bit of the color that I mixed with my acrylics over the airbrush section, so it will fade into one another. And that's the look I'm going for here. I don't want a harsh line there, so I'm just layering over some colors there. And like I said, here I'm building up with my airbrush. I'm coming through with the white, and then I'm glazing over my lightest colors, otherwise they wouldn't be as light as they should be. And here I'm building up my shadow parts on the deer painting. I like to start out with a mid-tone gray, so I better can see where I should go dark and where I should go lighter. And I'm leaving my brush strokes, especially in the early stages where I'm tinting the colors, I just leave those brush strokes because I want some texture there. And for the longer fur, I'm leaving the brush strokes in the right direction. That's very important because otherwise you can lose your texture. So therefore I try to build up right away in the right direction if I'm painting in fur, for example. So I can build up like I'm doing here with a bit of lighter tone. And most of the times it's unbleached Tartan white for me, and I'm glazing over, I'm tinting the color, and I'm building up again. And then I'm glazing over again and build up, and that's the way I paint, and just till I like it. So therefore, for fur, I use several layers. And also in this antlers were the lights and the darks very important, because I want to indicate that there is a section of the antler, of one of the antlers, is a bit further away than the other one. And to give this feeling of a antler who is a little bit further away, the lights and the darks are once again very important. And also you can give it shape, you can give it a round feel, or some of the antlers, some parts of the antlers are a little bended, and to give that indication I need my lights and the darks in a good place, and then comes the colors. But first of all the lights and the darks. And now the painting is looking a little bit flat, but I'm just building up my texture, and I try to paint in bit by bit my details and glaze over them. Try to indicate the ear, and the ear is almost fading the right to the viewer. So therefore once again my lights and my darks are very important to give that shape and the indication that the ear is sticking out and sticking towards the viewer. And also the highlights are very important in the eyes to give that realistic and that the feel of an animal who is alive. The lights and the white spots are very important for the eyes. And also, once again, I try to use as many colors as I can. You see me use some purple, some blue, and I'm building up again. I'm building over that purple, and maybe I'm putting in some brown to give a nice transition between the both and between the different colors. But I like to use as many colors as I can. Basically as many colors as I can, of course. I don't need yellows and reds, or if they not fit with my painting, but within my color range I try to use as many colors as I can. And here I'm really watching that I'm not making single brush strokes, but I want to give the indication of clumps of fur. So therefore I try to make a few brush strokes in movement, I should say, with my hand. I try to make a few lines there, so I indicate the clumps of fur, and we'll glaze over them again, and we'll make another fur, and that's how I'm building up. So here I'm using, I think, the burnt umber, I think, and the red oxide, and those colors, especially the red oxide, is a very, very rich red brownish color, and I used it quite a lot for this deer painting to let it stand out more, and especially also as airbrush background, it's very out of focus. It's a very nice to paint something in focus, and it's quite easy, and with a bit of vibrant colors, the deer will pop out of the painting very easily, because the airbrush will help you a lot if you do a out of focus background, and therefore I like to use some fiber colors to give that to let it stand out even a bit more. It's a really letting my subjects pop out of the painting or drawings. And here is the finished piece, and I have to say the colors aren't they don't show up as in real life. Sometimes it's hard to make a photo with the heavenly colors quite exact as the original piece, and I think it's of course I don't have a very very expensive camera, so that maybe if you have a better camera it will help, of course, but also a airbrush background, my camera can find it sometimes quite hard to get it in focus, and losing some vibrance in the colors there in his process there. So I hope one day I will have a better camera and can make even better photos than I can now.
Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below this video. And if you like, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and my own website. And of course, if you like, you can subscribe to my channel. I would really like that, because I see it as a compliment for my work. So if you like my work, please subscribe to my channel. And for now, I hope to see you at my next video. Bye bye!